हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर हेल्दी एंड फाइन एट योर होम, हैविंग गुड टाइम विथ योर फैमिली एज वेल एज डूइंग योर स्टडीज वेरी वेल. आई एम योर मेंटर शोभना हियर टू टीच यू सम टेक्सचुअल एक्टिविटीज विच आर गिवन इन योर साइंस टेक्स्ट बुक. ओके, सो हियर इन दिस एक्टिविटी we are going to discuss that how will you show and compare compressibility of gases and liquids. So in chapter 1, when we studied our chapter, we learned that gases and liquids, how they are compressible, and also learned the order of their compressibility, that gases are highly compressible, right? And its common example, if you remember, it was a gas cylinder which your mother is using for cooking purpose, right, in kitchen. So that cylinder is having gas which is highly compressed, and when gases, they are highly compressed, then what happens? It turns to liquid form. So that gas is stored in cylinder, and it shows that gases are compressible. So it's its common example. So in this activity, we are going to discuss compressibility of gases and liquid, and we are also going to compare the both, that how gases are compressible and how liquids are compressible. Now, what is required to perform this activity? We would need syringe of 2 ml and water and beaker. Now, how we are going to proceed for that? So here images are shown that how you are going to take all these things and perform this activity. You need to take a clean syringe and pull the piston outward. Okay, you are going to pull the piston outward so that you can have your syringe empty, and means your gas would be there, air would be there. Now block the nozzle of syringe with your thumb so that whatever air inside it would not release outside, and you can compress that air when you push that piston inward. Okay, so in second image here, you can see that you have closed that nozzle of syringe with your thumb, and you are pushing a piston of syringe from upward. You are pushing that piston inward. So air present inside that syringe is being compressed. Okay, so now you can push this piston to some limit, okay, and that is showing the compressibility of gas. Gas means here air is there, okay, so gases are compressible. Now you can repeat the same activity with water, and you can compare that how much amount of pressure you could apply, how much amount of that movement of piston downward was there. Okay, so it was greater in case of air. It was greater in first case where we were compressing air, and it was lesser in case of water. When you take water inside the syringe, that compressibility is less compared to first case where there was air inside the syringe. Okay, so from this activity, what you can say? You can say that gases are more compressible compared to liquids. Okay, so what have you learned? In case of air or gases, the piston could be pushed to some distance. In case of water, the piston did not move. And the second one, the above activity proves that gases are compressible, whereas liquids are not. Sometimes liquids are not compressible, or if they are compressible, they are less compressible in comparison to air. Okay, so when you compare gases and liquids, which one is more compressible? Yes, gases, or you can say air, they are more compressible in comparison of gases. Okay, so in first activity, you learnt this main important point, compressibility of gases and liquid, that gases and liquids are compressible, okay, while solids are not. And if you compare the both, then gases and liquids, they are compressible, but gases are more compressible than liquids. Okay, and which apparatus you required you required here syringe, water and beaker. Okay, so in beaker you took water and syringe. First of all, you are going to use this syringe while it is empty. Okay, and you need to press the syringe with your thumb. And in second case, you are going to just press that piston downward and trying to compress that air inside the syringe. So you can compress it to some amount of level. And in second case, what you did, you took water in beaker. Now you tried to fill that syringe with water and repeat the same activity which you did with first case. Okay, so you just fill up that syringe with water and again close it with your thumb, close the nozzle of syringe with your thumb and try to push the piston downward. Then what happens in this case, you are not able to just press the piston to more than some extent. Okay, and if you compare both the cases, then compressibility of air is greater than compared to water. Okay, so this activity explains us that gases, they are more compressible than liquids. I hope this point is clear. Now let us move to the second activity of this chapter also. The second activity is that how will you determine the boiling point of water and melting point of ice. Okay, we learned this phenomenas, we learned these terms, boiling point of water, the temperature at which water starts boiling, that is boiling point, and melting point of ice, wherever ice start turning to water. Okay, means it's solid state, it interconverts into liquid state. So the temperature at which this happens, that is melting point of ice. So here, in this activity is divided into two parts. Its first part A is determination of boiling point of water. So how you will determine the boiling point of water? What is required for this activity? For this, first one, you will require fusion tube. Fusion tube and capillary tube, tripod, kerosene, burner, thermometer, aluminium block, pasteur pipette and stand with clamp. Okay, let us see how this apparatus look like. Here all this apparatus is labeled up. You can see here. First one, they say fusion tube. Okay, so this fusion tube, which is having a shape like a cup. Okay, in which we are going to have our liquid filled. Then tripod, metallic block is there. And burner is there. Capillary tube is also there. And thermometer is there, and all this thermometer is also fitted with clamp stand. So with this apparatus, we are going to determine boiling point of water. So how we are going to do this, that is given in this point here, which steps we need to follow. First step is that infusion tube transfer 4 to 5 drops of water with help of pasteur pipette and place it on one of the holes of aluminium block. So here, that is BP and MP apparatus, means boiling point and melting point apparatus. Care should be taken that water level in fusion tube is visible after placing it in the hole. Seal one end of capillary tube in the flame of kerosene burner and dip the open end of capillary tube into water, infusion tube. Now you can see that here this capillary tube is inserted in this fusion tube, and after that thermometer is also inserted in the same. And second step is inserting thermometer in the second hole of this aluminium block. Metal block is labeled here. Here it is given that metal block, and that metal is aluminium here. After that, put the aluminium block on the tripod stand and heat the apparatus with help of kerosene burner. Okay, we need to determine the boiling point. So we are going to provide heat to water. So you can see here that under tripod stand we have arranged this kerosene burner, which will provide the heat to water. So put the aluminium block
on the tripod stand and heat the apparatus with the help of kerosene burner slowly. Now observe what happens to water. Do you see any bubbles arising slowly in the fusion tube? Now, when this bubbles arises, you need to record the temperature when you observe a steady stream of bubbles. Okay? When these bubbles, they are continuously rising and you can see a steady stream of bubbles, then you are going to note the temperature. And this temperature is going to determine the boiling point of water. So, do you observe any further rise in temperature after a steady stream of bubbles started coming out? So, here, and next portion is given that boiling point of water remains constant during the boiling of water. Okay. So, boiling point of water can be determined by this method. Fine. And in the same activity, the second part is given that you need to determine melting point of ice. And for that, what is required? You need micro beaker of 10 ml, stand with clamp and thermometer, cork and ice. So you need ice because you are going to determine melting point of ice. Now, how will you proceed? You need to take a crush ice in micro beaker and insert a thermometer in the beaker by hanging it from the clamp of the stand in such a way that bulb of thermometer is completely inside the ice. Only after that it's able to measure the temperature here. You can see here the thermometer, its bulb is just inside the ice. Okay, it's completely inside the ice. Wait for some time and keep recording the temperature after small intervals of time. Note down the temperature when ice just starts melting. Okay. Whenever temperature is enough and ice starts melting, this is the point which you are going to determine. Okay, what this point is? Melting point of ice. Now, let the bulb of thermometer remain in mixture of ice and water for some more time and keep recording the temperature. Do you observe further change in temperature? Once ice starts melting, here the temperature would remain constant. Okay, the melting point of ice is remaining constant during the melting of ice. Okay, so here this is the main point which we learned from both the activities in determining boiling point of water, that once water starts boiling, that would be boiling point of water, that is 100 degrees Celsius, and melting point of water, melting point of ice, that is 0 degrees Celsius. Okay, so after ice starts melting or after water starts boiling, that melting point or boiling point remains the constant, it's not changing. That is the conclusion we can have from both this activity. Okay, so what apparatus we took for both the activities? Here, for first activity, to determine boiling point, we took fusion tube in which we took water, capillary tube which was showing the rise of bubbles, tripod stand, kerosene burner, thermometer to measure temperature, aluminium block, pressure pipette, stand with clamp. Okay, see, all these things we took and arranged the apparatus as shown here in figure. Okay, and all these things are labeled up here, that in clamp stand we allow a thermometer to hold it. Then a capillary tube we inserted in one hole, and in another hole we inserted thermometer. And in this fusion tube we took water, okay, and burner was taken for providing heat to water. When water starts boiling, we measured temperature and found out that what the boiling point of water is. And after that, we keep on providing heat, but the temperature remains constant. Okay, so we can have a conclusion that even if we continue providing heat, once water starts boiling, its temperature is remaining the same. Clear? Okay. Next activity which we learned, that showed us that melting point of ice can be determined by using this apparatus. In one micro beaker of 10 ml, we took ice and kept it on tripod. Here we don't need to provide heat because ice would start melting
at room temperature also. So at some intervals of time, we are measuring the temperature, or say change in temperature, from the thermometer, and note down these observations. And as soon as ice just start melting, we record the temperatures. And finally, we just came to a conclusion that once ice starts melting, its temperature remains same.